Hello guys, and welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to create a shooting system, and I will explain in this part of a serie, and in this serie I will explain how to create a basic FPS game. It will only have the basic, so nothing very special. And the first thing is how to shoot, and well, let me just show you. For those breakable objects, you find a tutorial in the description of this object, and also this system has access to multiple bullets, and well, this is the normal one, a triple bullet and an explosion, and that's everything. So welcome back by the tutorial, and first let me explain the whole scene. So here's just a basic FPS controller, only it also contains the FPS controller script we are going to create today. Well, I'm not going to explain anything of this because I will explain it in the script itself. Then we got an UE camera, and it's just a camera to have the basic UE. Nothing special, just a few panels, and the, here's the both images to create this crosshair, and a few images to where the bullets will stand on. But it's a little bit important, not very much, but it's just to make sure you can see which bullet is next, and this one is the one you can shoot current, and this one is well, the one who will come after that. And also here you got an empty game object, and it is to where the bullets will spam from, so nothing very important except it has to rotate 90 degrees. Also, this canvas needs to be random mode for screen space camera, and the camera, the UE camera, has to have a depth of 1, just to make sure it will render over the normal first person character camera. And also this one doesn't need to see the UE, and this one only will see the UE. Well, and other bullets, nothing very special, just a spare, and with a collider, a rigid body, the bullet controller script I will explain, and a trial render. I won't explain this one also. This is just graphics, and I won't explain graphics in this tutorial series, or you need to ask about it. But two exactly the same, only I just duplicated this a few times. Bullet 3 is a little bit different from the other ones. I just created a simple explosion bullet kind of thing, but nothing very special. A destructible game object, and it's just an explosion actually. So and it's just from the basic explosions system, particle system from the standard assets, and just a sound of an explosion that will play on awake. And I think that's everything. Also very important, use explosion mobile, because otherwise it will take a long time to render. And if you got a mine menu, you also need to add all those game objects to the scene, just to make sure they are already loaded before you can shoot for the first time. Otherwise you have a frame rate drop. So let me now explain the script. So first, you're using the collections, that's very important, and the UE, well, I think it's clear, this is just for a list, and this is just because you are using UE. And first, it has any of all the bullet sorts. You need to add them on your own, so it's just in the script you need to change that. That's a kind of a shame, but well, it works. And also you have a class of a bullet, and you have a name for it, and it's just most of the times you will only use it in the editor itself and not for the game, but sometimes you will and know, maybe you want to do something with it. You got also a sprite of an image, And that's the image you see here. And also you got a game object prefab, and the prefab is this game object. But then of course in your asset folder, sometimes it is a random bullet, so it won't shoot startup, and it will just have a random rotation to it. You got both lists of them. You got two lists of the bullets. You got one bullet list of all the bullets you have, and a list of bullet sorts of all the current bullets, and that will look like this. And then I can also explain a little bit about it. Because here you got all the source bullets, and you can only add bullets you already got in the script here, and here you will change all the current bullets. And ammo needs to be exactly the same as how many current bullets you have, otherwise you will get an error, but that's something for different. Here you can just use, for example, if I use explosive shot there, you'll see the first one is an explosive shot. So that's just for yourself, just to make it very clear how which bullets are next. The next thing is a private float shoot time, just to make sure, just to check how many time after you shoot the last time. And also you've got a fire rate, so you can make this fire rate, if you put it to zero, you have an automatic gun, and otherwise you just need to click one by one. Also you've got the transfer spawn point where the bullet will spawn. You've got an int ammo. There's just a variable just to make everything a little bit more easier. You've got all the images of the ammo UE, and it's are just all the images of this one. And this one is the bullet you are actually going to shoot with, so the big one. This one is that one, and this one is that one. And you also got a sprite nothing, and that's when you only got two bullets left, but you got three images here. The last one will just be empty. For me this works, and also in many games you got an icon like there is nothing, so you can also change it right here on this at this UE image. And there's also a float of timer at the start. It will change all the bullet stats, just to make sure you've got the right images here, here, and here. And the bullet start looks like this. It will, for each image from the image in the ammo UE, so that are all the images you assigned here, from here, from this one, those images, and it will check if the ammo minus one is greater than zero, and it will just get the sprite of the image of what you assigned in the bullet class, and otherwise it will set the sprite to nothing, and after that it will add to I one, and it will do the whole loop again. Then every frame it will update the shoot controller, and the reason I did it within other void instead of just update it is a little bit faster. If you put it in a void, it's around 0.5 frames each second. It will be faster, but it's just a little bit, and I think it's better to optimize as much as possible. And it will check if you shoot, so if if input cat button down, and if the shoot time is the time dot time is less than the time dot time, so you'll make sure you won't shoot too many times at once. And it will also check if the ammo is more than zero, because otherwise you you will shoot with nothing. It will see what the current bullet is, so that's from the sword bullets, and then, well, the first one, and it will just change the shoot time, and it will add make instantiate a prefab of the current bullet, and it's the prefab you assigned here, and it will check the spawn point position and spawn point rotation, and here it will change all the rigid bullets, or it will get all the rigid bullets in the instantiated bullet, and that makes sure you can create bullets like this one, where you got 3 bullets, and then it will, for each rigid bully in the rigid bully, it will make a random number, and it will be a random number between the number you assigned here, the minus, and also just a positive one, and it will add a relative force to the body with minus 15. This is important, you have to add here, or you can also, if you want to have to build it a little bit faster, you can increase this number, and you need to add a random number, 0 with a random number, 0 with a random number, this random number, and the force mode will be impulse, and the ammo will be minus 1. From the current bullet you will remove the first one, so you won't shoot again and again and again the same one, and after that it will update the bullet stats. And that's the whole script for the FPS controller, and now the bullet controller, so that's the one which you assign to the bullet, that will have a damage float, so you can assign how many damage it's got, and also if it got a speciality, and from and that's the bullet sort, and it is or normal or it is explosive, or you can add as many as you want, and hit prefab, and that's a prefab, if you hit something it will add that prefab, but that's only sometimes. So at start it will destroy itself within 5 seconds, you can increase this number, but normally games can't handle it if this is too big, and on collision enter it will send a message upwards from cat bullet damage, the damage, and it don't require a receiver. If you don't add this, you will get some errors. And if the bullet sword is explosive, it will also destroy this game object immediately, otherwise it will just, well, as you can see here, the explosive one will delete itself directly, but the other one will just roll around. You can also do this for every bullet if you've got another FPS, and it will instantiate the hit prefab on this positions and this rotation. So that were all the scripts. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe, and if you've got any questions, please comment them below. And I see you guys next week.